Today, we're on a glacier in Iceland. This is the Strokkur Geyser. It goes up every 5 to 10 minutes.
That was a good one.
Oh, that's big there. Look at that.
That is massive.
Now, I've got something different in mind. Of all the phantoms we've ever used, this is the biggest.
I'm nervous for his drone and the camera. He might get hit.
Holy crap. Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Well, looking back on that, I think that was the most challenging conditions I've ever shot in.
And it smelled really eggy.
It smells a bit like eggs.
Sorry, that was me, that one.
Oh, was that you?
Yeah.
By far the sketchiest position that Phantom camera has ever been in is hovering above a hole in the earth and then getting battered with water.
Oh! Jesus Christ!
Holy crap!
The amount of stress running through my body when I was watching that.
It's quite cool that we had the opportunity to have the camera flying above what we were filming.
Yeah, it's never been that high, no. Ever. I also thought it'd be very cool if we brought along a thermal camera to see the difference in temperature between us and the water. So let's take a look at that.
Would you like to tell us about this camera?
Yeah, this is a FLIR thermal imaging camera. This is actually a cooled camera, and what it basically does, it measures temperatures.
This is like 80 to 100 degrees.
Yeah, basically every pixel is a temperature measurement, so you can be really detailed on what you want to measure it.
So should we have it so that it's further back and I'm in the frame, so I'm just shivering my...
Let's see what that looks like.
Shivering and then, yeah.
Oh, I guess I'm not operating. I could be in there with you.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Well, hey! Yeah. All right, let's do it. It's a bit cold, isn't it?
It's pretty chilly.
Well, it's like 1 degree.
Something like that. And it's raining as well.
Yeah. Shouldn't be long, though, until it goes off.
I like this one because it's only like every 5 minutes this one goes off.
Check this out, ready?
Oh!
There you go. All right, how was that? Look at our little faces.
I look like I'm evil. My eyes are warmer than the rest
of my
face.
You're leaking heat through your eyes and neck. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's crazy.
Cool.
Yeah, that's wicked.
All the steam bar, that's really cool.
And this is the software that the FLIR cameras use, so we can actually see some values. Firstly, let's just see how cold my nose was. 56.
What is that guff number?
Fahrenheit. Oh. You gotta change it.
Change it.
Let's get on Celsius.
I like how your nose is so much colder than your face because it's so far away from the blood flow.
Got a 14 degree nose. But my eyelids are 23. All right, let's play on.
And what you got to remember is it's actually really cold outside, so it's so quick to turn into cool water.
You see how quickly it fades off and becomes your greens and your blues.
That's wicked.
Looks like a rainbow got nuked.
It does.
Yeah, all the stuff that's still bubbling is the hottest. Yeah, 60.
70 degrees there.
Oh, something I've always wanted to find out.
Yeah?
Let's have a quick look at your heart.
Ooh. Cold as ice.
Cold as ice, 5 degrees.
Yeah.
With an asterisk, so it's probably like, it's too cold.
Because we filmed it in RAW, it meant that we could edit this as we're going in this software.
Well, let's see what the highest temperature it hits is through that through the whole thing.
Spot the 87 is pretty high. 86, 85, 83, 82. It's going down. So it's at the beginning of the eruption was the highest temperature. Around here.
87.
Yeah. 87.9, about 88.
88, and that's probably... Yeah,
said,
it's the hottest it's been.
So pretty much as soon as it's burst its bubble, that's when it's the hottest. And it turns cooler.
I think we've learned a lot of good stuff there.
So I've never actually seen anything like a geyser in real life. It's kind of surreal. Although I don't actually know what's happening, so.
I mean, we spent all day there and it's still kind of confusing how that works.
A complete mystery.
Yeah.
So now we've got John Cotter with us, who's a professor of geography and environmental science, who can hopefully take us through exactly what's happening.
We also have this lovely experiment. Do you want to run us through this?
Okay, well, water's going to be flowing downhill, and as it flows downhill, it's going to start seeping into the ground. So as it's coming down deep below, there has to be some kind of a boiler. And so that water's going to get in there, it's going to start heating up, and once that starts boiling like that, it's going to start getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And as it rises, that heavier, more dense water is just going to come and flow underneath it. And that gives it a little bit more spring. And once that spring starts, you've got a jet heading upstream.
It's amazing that it's so deep and so narrow.
Yeah.
It's phantom time. John, do you want to explain how this experiment works for us?
Okay, let's start with the hot plate down here. This represents the magma that's going to be heating up the water. And these bubbles are getting bigger and bigger and coalescing at the top of the beaker. Once that bubble gets big enough, it's going to have enough momentum to start climbing. So if you're on the surface looking down on this thing, what you're going to see is this bubble starting to rise. That tells you that blast is right on the way.
Here we go. Back up.
Oh, it's about to go.
Oh, spectacular.
Why did we go to Iceland?
Sounds like you after a curry.
Yeah, I was going to say the same thing. I was going to make the same joke, but I thought it'd be in poor taste.
You saw the water go back down.
Oh,
that was cool.
So it's going to do it again and build up again for a second eruption.
Oh, yeah. It's a very realistic scale.
Wait, why am I way fatter than you are?
I don't know.
Just spotted that.
Someone's made like a, I like how oddly similar this tiny experiment is.
It's exactly the same. It works the same thing. You get the bubbles of water coming up, building up, and then erupting. It's exactly the same.
That's what's great about the universe. It's quite consistent.
Yeah, that's true.
So, John, is this exactly what you expected from this experiment?
I think it's very good, except these tourists need to stand a little further away.
A bit too close, aren't we? Well, we cleaned the ceiling.
It's boiling hot water.
Spotless now.
Yeah, that's great. Thanks very much, John, for your help.
Appreciate it.
I actually really feel like I've learned something there.
Glad to have had a chance to meet you.
Yeah.
Take care.
Very nice to meet you, too. Hopefully, you enjoyed that episode. Feel free to subscribe to the Slow-Mo Guys and check out other episodes from Planet Slow-Mo.
The Slow-Mo Geyser.
Slow-Mo Geyser.
Why did we only just think of it?
That's great.
Yeah.
Doesn't really work the way we pronounce it, but...
Fine.
That's what I mean. Yeah. Buttons are over there.